finally here. Welcome. I've been waiting for your arrival. This place? This is a realm of dreams. I've guided you here from your own dream world to meet me here. Don't worry, in the real world you're already in a deep sleep. I am simply here as a guard for your dreams, to keep you from having any unpleasant slumber. Why? Well, there's nothing wrong with wanting to spend time with a friend who means so much to me, but I also had another reason. I was recently contacted by an old acquaintance. Or maybe acquaintance isn't the best word. Anyway, I received an earnest plea requesting that I make sure your dreams are pleasant this evening. I believe his exact words were, "Please make sure my Windbloom has a dream free from worry." I'm not sure of all the details, but it seems someone is indeed very worried about you. I've been informed you've been sleeping poorly recently. No need to explain. Come and sit with me for a while. The real you is getting some much-needed rest. We might as well chat while we spend some time together. Lay down if you'd like. This dream was made with your comfort in mind. I went through extra effort to make sure you would be able to relax in this place. I want to make sure you're calm first, though. This is your first time in a dream world of this design, so some fatigue may be normal at first. For starters, take a deep breath, okay? Did you know? When you take a really deep breath, you're supposed to be able to feel it in your tummy. Take a deep breath. In. And out. Good job. It's nothing. It's just... I can tell. Even though I've closed your mind off to intruders, there's still some bad dreams trying to pry inside. Don't worry, I won't let them in. This is my domain, and I won't allow anything in that can hurt you. I've been tasked with giving you a pleasant sleep, and I won't let anything wake you up just yet. Close your eyes, okay? I'm going to take a deeper look inside your mind for just a moment. Don't worry, because you're currently asleep, I shouldn't have to look very deep to find the root of those nightmares. Just close your eyes. Take another deep breath. Rid of those. Take another deep breath. There. These seem to have subsided for now. Nothing to thank me for. It's only natural that if a friend is suffering, you want to be able to help them. Is something on your mind? I only ask because poor sleep and bad dreams are deeply linked to the subconscious, one's emotional state. If you're having trouble with nightmares, there's probably something bothering you in the real world too, whether you're aware of it or not. Two heads are better than one. Maybe I can help you. Or... If getting to the root of your problems is too complex, we can start with something simple. Is there something that you're seeking? Maybe I can manifest it into your dreams for you. If you had to pick something that you want, what would it be? I may not understand your exact worries in this case, but at the base of it all, you're just hoping to be happy, right? Happiness. It's a very good thing to reach for, both in dreams and in reality. After all, everyone is chasing happiness in some way. However, there is a right way to obtain it. How? Rather than telling you the answer immediately myself, allow me to tell you a story. Don't worry, I won't take too large of a detour from your main inquiry, and as the god of wisdom, I think this particular case may be relevant to your cause. Okay. A long time ago, there were two scholars both tasked with making a quantifiable route to happiness. There was one scholar who proposed that in order to become happy, one must abandon all desires. But there was yet another scholar who proposed that fulfilling desires is the only way to become happy. They argued about it for years and years, and as the god of wisdom, I watched over their debate. You see, they both have the potential to be right, but they both also have the potential to be wrong. Take the first scholar. He may be right. If people abandon all of their desires, the desire for comfort, the desire for wealth, the desire for delicious food, the desire to be loved. If they need nothing at all, then they have nothing to satisfy, and thus they will never be dissatisfied. They will never be disappointed if they never have any dreams. But can a person truly be a person without any desires at all? Can a life be fully lived without desiring anything? But for instance, take the second scholar. It stands to reason that fulfilling all desires could lead to happiness. But if all you ever do is chase every desire you have, will you ever be able to satisfy them all? Those who chase two rabbits catch none, and so does one who chases everything obtain nothing. The scholars quarreled over this, and their debate went on for decades, until they both eventually came to the end of their lives, with their theories both unfinished and unproven. You'd think they would have been bitter till the end. After all, both were unable to walk the very path to happiness they were trying so desperately to prove. The first was clearly unable to throw away all of his desires and his desire to be right, and the second was unable to fulfill his desire to be right. But I can truthfully declare that both of them were incredibly happy until the very end of their days. The funny thing is, neither of them were able to include their own route to happiness in their papers because they never realized it themselves. The smiles on their faces when they were sharing their ideas with each other. For both of these scholars, debating their thoughts with each other brought them the most happiness. They spent their lives doing the thing they loved the most. How could they be anything but happy? Their own personal definition of happiness escaped their cognition until the very end. Don't you see? Trying to define a route to happiness that works categorically for everyone. This was the largest lapse in both of these scholars' wisdom. People often try to say this is the answer to happiness or this is the meaning of life. These are the words of fools. Not because happiness is unobtainable or because there is no meaning of life, but because that changes for every person. Human lives are intricate. Life itself is often fluid. And so is happiness. It's the same feeling, but it takes a different shape for every person, depending on their desires. For example, some direct their attention inward for happiness, seeking to love themselves, desiring self-improvement, seeking to find authenticity within their own selves, while others direct their attention outward for happiness, seeking things from the world, seeking experiences, seeking love from others, seeking the words that they want to hear the most. And neither method is incorrect. For example, even between just you and me, I imagine that my happiness might look very different from your happiness, and the same applies to others. Some people are satisfied with a quiet and simple life with modest wealth spent with those close to them. Others crave adventure and grandeur and wealth beyond reason. Some crave knowledge, while others find their happiness in ignorance. Some find bliss in solitude, while others feel most whole when they're surrounded by many people. None of these are incorrect, you know. The only way an ideology becomes incorrect is if they try to force it to apply to everyone. There's a reason why so much of this world is filled with a multitude of color. Very few things before us are meant to be viewed strictly in black and white, and your happiness may indeed be shrouded in multiple colors as well. You know, the reason I told you this story is, oftentimes, finding the definition of one's happiness is the hardest part of becoming happy. If you're unable to put a name to it, if you're unable to define it for yourself, it may escape your cognition just like it did for those scholars. You may not realize your happiest moments until it's already too late. So, what makes you smile? What makes your heart bounce around with excitement? What are the things that make the world seem colorful to you? If you find the answer to that and incorporate it into your life, happiness will always follow. I truly hope you already know the answer to your happiness. But if you don't yet, that's okay too. You have lots of time to find it. Everyone has one, and as the God of Wisdom, I can help you seek it out from an array of information sources. What I mean to say is, I and so many other people want for you to be happy, and no matter what form it takes for you. It's okay if it takes a while, or if you stumble upon the way. But once you find your answer, I want you to hold on to it, okay? Whatever is important to you, I'm sure it's something very worthwhile. Please don't worry. You'll be okay. And I'll support you in what you need, whether it be words of encouragement, or if you simply need me to guard your dreams for a while. Keeping nightmares away is no trouble for me, and I promise I'll help you, just like you did for me. Okay? Good. Well now that that's out of the way, would you like to play some games together? We still have a lot of time before it's time for you to wake up, and we can play any game you want here. Or if you don't feel like playing games, the one who requested I guard your dreams this evening also gave me an extensive list of the things you like, so I can make this dream as happy as possible for you. This dream exists only to make you smile, and I'll do my best to fulfill that purpose. Mm-hmm. thank you? That should be my line. You've helped me so much, Traveler. And now it's my turn to help you. I'm glad. Then, let's go play, okay? Don't worry. I'll be sure to make this a very happy dream.